Hello, good evening and welcome. God damn it, why must I always say good evening? Because, you know, for me it's a good evening because I'm drinking. Woohoo! But I don't know, a lot of people watch me in the morning sometimes while they're getting themselves dressed and farting and stuff like that. Yeah, they say, oh, I'll put you on while I'm getting dressed in the morning, you know, it's great. I'll put you on me like telly and all that business and watch you while I'm like doing all this and blue train. A blue train. Is that actually a word? It's doing you ablutions, isn't it? I know ablutions is a word, you know, but a blue train. Yeah, I've just made it up. Anyway, I do digress. One I am hoping good things for, because I've tasted this on cask and it's lovely. Down at the JBBF, if you're gonna have a look around by all means, but you've got to try the Green King stand and the Thwaites stand. Fuller's stand's good, you know. Fuller's brewery's fantastic, but Fuller's stand's good. Not quite as good as the others. They seem to keep really great stands in it. I don't know if there's the Thwaites still doing the same now that our Ian's gone and that, you know. And it's kind of, to me, it's slightly sad that he's not there anymore. But look, he's gone on to bigger and better things, maybe. I don't know. He's gone on to different things, anyway. But anyway, thoroughly good beers, it says. And thoroughly spelt correctly on the top. But it's a Thwaites Lancaster Bomber. Now, as much as you got the 13 guns and other big, Old Dan, I think it is, or stuff like that. You got all sorts of the Big Ben and things. And they've had some really beautiful beers out there, big beers and that lately. Really gorgeous beers. But they're kind of more of their showpieces than it. Now this is one of their ones that's a kind of run-of-the-mill, their day-day, kind of day-day sort of beers than it. And I don't know if this is their most popular beer, but it's certainly one of them. Anyway, it says on the back here, classic English ale, chestnut in colour, blah, blah, load of tosh about describing it. Twice voted English bitter at the European Beer Star Awards. Quite simply the best of British beer. Well, I will tell you about that. But extra special bitter. At 4.4. Okay. Anyway, it's an ESB, 4.4. It's the Lancaster Bomber, best of British. At the GBBF, I had this and it was lovely, really lovely. So I'm going to whack it open now. And see. Beautiful. There's the thoroughly good beers. Which is always nice to know. Let's pour that out, if I can swap hands. I'm ambidextrous, but I'm ambidextrous in a strange way. Certain things that I can, you know, if I learn something with one hand, like golf, say, or something like that, I can play it just as well with the other hand, more or less. About 90% as well with the other hand. Sometimes better. If I have a bad day with my right hand, I can go, can I borrow your left-handed golf clubs? Whack. Yeah, I'm back on it, you know. Darts, pool. If I learn anything with one hand. But funny enough, pouring beers, I have trouble pouring with the left hand. Yeah, drinking, I'll pick up with whatever hand, and I'll drink it with this hand, drink it with that hand. And the same with anything, putting. When I used to, I don't play golf anymore, but when I used to, I would putt. I had a two-sided putter. That's, you know, the putter's got a slight thing like that to it. And it didn't have a scoop on one side and all that. It had just a normal two-sided putter. Whatever, I didn't even notice, whatever way I'd walk up to the ball, if the hole was that way and I was over this side, I'd walk up to the ball and putt it that way. Didn't even notice, and if it was the other way, I'd walk up and putt it that way. And didn't even notice the difference, never did. So, you know, there. But funny enough, I pour I can't pour some well with that end. I seem to mess it up. I think it's to do with the pouring that way. If you pour it straight down, I can pour with this end easily. If I'm pouring it, the 12 seems to go wrong. Anyway, have I gone off the point? Let's have a sniff. Let's have a look first. Look, we're talking about northern beer. And Manchester, I believe. I think Freight's in it, around that area. So, look, there we go. There's the head a little bit. Die down rate. I always like to have a look at the die down rate in it. It's coming down naturally, which is good. Carbonation, everything's looking nice. Colour is looking good. Pretty. Right, sniffs. Yeah, smells nice. As it happens, I've twirled so much head in there that I can't smell it. Got it. Oh, smells really nice. If you're getting, you know when you get penne, you know, the bread, you know, the Italian bread, and you cut it open, you toast one side, you get them aromas coming off the top, that. You're getting that coming off, almost like a croissant-y sort of smell, but not that sweet. You're getting little edges of something that Ah, got it. Not quite got it. I'll hang about. If your nose gets worn out, do this. Smell something very neutral. Your skin's got its own smell, but it's really quite neutral in it. It refreshes the nose, and then when you smell something, the nose will go, whoa, there we go. Still not got it. There's something weird in there. Course, a really elusive little character. He's big. He's not big, massive, but he's in there, but he's hiding. It's one of them, once you identify it, then it seems bigger. No, I'm missing him. I got him a minute ago almost. Yeah. He's like a slight edge of a panettone, that little currenty edge in bread. If you took all the currants out, that little edge left behind. Something like that, but not quite there. Something a little bit strange. Almost that, but caramelised slightly. The as if you've caramelised that fruit. It's really delicate though, it's not there. Right, other notes. Slight little dry oaky notes, but without that delicious oakiness. It's dry wood, like lolly sticks. Slight little caramel edges, slight little biscuity edges, or not quite caramel, biscuity edges, like a custard cream without the cream in there, you know. As if you licked the cream off and then had the rest of it after. It's not massive on the nose, it's not a lot there. I'm going to go in and try the palate now. Cheers, everyone. It's nice, delicate, it's lovely. There's nice little flavours in there. There's a bitter edge, there's a bitter finish. There's a slight, I don't know how to say this, because I love Thwaites, but sometimes you can taste that bitterness coming off of like a colouring bitterness. Very tiny, very, very tiny, and it's difficult to tell the difference between that and a drying hop, between certain kind of, certainly beta acids in that. Some of them are dry, and I've got a dry finish. Not the alpha acids in hops, which, you know, are usually the bitter in hops, but those dry beta acids as well. And sometimes you get that with an edge to them. Like a burnt edge to them that shouldn't belong there. It's nice though. It is nice. And I ain't saying it's got colouring or anything in it. I ain't saying it's got anything in it. But it's just, there's certain edges. Sometimes you can taste certain esters. You can taste, you know, so many people shout diacetyls and esters and things like that. You can taste esters, you can taste diacetyls, you can taste certain salts and things in beers, certain minerals and things like that. You can taste them, you know. If you want to taste minerals, start with Andrew's salts. Have a little taste, get yourself familiar with that. And then taste different beers, and certain beers you'll go, I recognise that, that's your Andrew's salts. Look down your Andrew's salts ingredients. You'll pick certain ones out that are in the waters around the area. You know, study the waters around the area. Have a look at if it's a Pennines beer, have a look at the Pennines water and what's in there, you know, what's the proliferations in their kind of the water in that area. So if they're using Pennines water, it's got different character than Burton water, say, Burton on the Trent water, Burton iced water, or whatever. Anyway, I'm going off the thing. It's still a very, very lovely beer. It's a very lovely, very, very drinkable beer. It's not doing anything special. It's not doing anything extraordinary. It's doing its job, is what it's doing. It's doing a sessionable kind of beer job of not being anything really special. Now, when I had it at the GBBF, it was a very sessionable beer, but it had a certain lovely quintessential Britishness about it, which was just beautiful. It's nice. It's really nice. So it is definitely a try bite and like it. Bum 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 bum. Try bite and like it without a doubt. But it won't set your pants on fire. So it's lovely, it's nice. Try it, bite and like it without a doubt. It's holding its head beautifully. Just holding the right amount of head, just a little bit to set little worlds and islands and patterns on there, you know. Anyway, bottoms up, chin chin, cheers. See you next one. Don't be late.